One thing everyone who has played a game in the Xeno franchise should know is that there's almost always a deeper meaning to everything. The games are layers of gambit, symbolism, and references upon a Mobius strip. One of the most surprising things I discovered is what the Monado references and is based on. There is a concept in the science of physics that there may be a limit to how much something can be divided before it becomes impossible to divide further. The Monado is what you have when you divide something down to the smallest it can be, and it becomes absolutely indivisible. We can break visible objects into molecules, and molecules into atoms, and atoms into electrons and protons, and those subatomic structures into quarks, hadrons, bosons, mesons, and many other particles. But the theory proposing the Monad suggests eventually everything ultimately breaks down into a Monad. Every atom is composed of countless Monads, and everything we can perceive is made up of an infinitely growing number of Monads. The Monad also has symbolism in religious philosophy and metaphysical science as well, and could be defined as the absolute origin, or the purest form, of the God that must exist for anything else to exist, regardless of if it is a sentient being or an impersonal force that by pure chance created everything. This talk of particles and various aspects of philosophy, all being closely related, meaning in the most general sense, the Monad could be described as the absolute origin or basis of all things, the smallest any measurable thing can be, and the literal Alpha and Omega Ouroboros, yin and yang of existence and reality. The thing that exists above and outside of space and time, that is all that innately exists and will always exist. And anything else that exists, exists purely as an extension of the Monad. Leibniz came up with his own concept he called the Monad, which was each unique perspective of reality that only a true God could completely understand. In the discussion of Xeno, Xeno is that gap between Leibniz's Monads, or each individual perspective that he believed only God could fill or bypass. So you are probably asking how this all connects to Xenoblade, or maybe you are figuring it out already. I'm sure some of you are also lost in rewinding the video if this is your first exposure to this extent of free-thinking philosophy. First, I have to make a brief detour to Xenosaga, where the game stated certain major characters had extremely strong wills that granted them various abilities such as persistence in the mortal realm after death, and the ability to use devices powered directly by God. I'm trying not to spoil anything with that detour. You signed up for Xenoblade spoilers watching this video, not Xenosaga spoilers. In a similar sense, the Monado could be the indivisible part of the will, or the absolute origin of the will. Sansa and Mayneth both created Monado-powered swords as their wills for the new universe, and by being exposed to these wills, being able to challenge fate, and learning the truth, Shulk's will evolve to become as indivisible. But there's one other thing. Remember that Alvis, the former computer, was the Monado. Within the domain of the new universe he created, he was the closest thing to a god, and was the origin, swayed by the clash of three wills to give birth to a new universe. Everything comes together, the indivisible part of the soul, the origin of all things within the domain, and the view of all Monados or perspectives by the god. This is definitely fitting for Monolith to base a plot around, considering how close the Monad ties to many of the inspirations in Xenosaga.